quite the excitement level here since taking over as head coach at Mississippi State, generating a buzz in Starkville.
For three straight years, the Saints came to Jackson and held training camp at Millsaps College. This year, they stayed in New Orleans, and they're going to the Super Bowl.
You have found us again. I'm glad you did. I'm Travis Raycheck, ready for another night of the Dr. Pepper Sports Desk.
With Ole Miss taking a huge win over Texas Tech in the Cotton Bowl, 47-34.
The first ever 6A championship game was played tonight. We had a lot of talent on the field. We had a lot of snow on the field, an absolutely wild one.
And he is ready to make a decision in the studio with us. We want to bring in Julissus Nobles. It is decision day for you.
I want to start by asking you about the last image a lot of people around the country saw is the broken leg in the bowl game.
Southern Miss knew their season would end at some point here in Omaha. They were just hoping it wouldn't be so quickly.
We bring in sports director Travis Raycheck. Travis.
Hey, Kathy. No one really saw this coming, but what fans in Hattiesburg saw Saturday night was maybe the moment of the year in college football.
32, senior Martez Smith.
SEC Media Days coming to a close, and the last team to talk, the Ole Miss Rebels.
All right, after talking with Dominique, I couldn't get it out of my head. He reminded me of somebody, and you may think I'm crazy, but just take a look at this. Tell me, you see it? Huh? No? Come on, what about this picture? No? What about this one? All right, that has nothing to do with anything.
Comeback stories in sports can be inspiring. Comeback stories that take four decades to complete, pretty much unheard of until you meet this Holmes Community College kicker.
He gets ready like a normal football player, but Alan Moore is not like every other guy on the team.
It's a lot different than it was in 68.
As in 1968. Yes, that was the last time Alan Moore played football. Now, it was about this time a year ago that the Taylorsville native spawned an idea to make an improbable comeback.
Went outside and started kicking. Bought a practice tee. It took me about 8 weeks to get one up off the ground. It's the first time I touched football in 42 years.
The obvious rust wore off and persistence paid off after many colleges turned him away. But Holmes provided Moore one more chance.
It's a great story of perseverance and then making up your mind you're going to make a commitment to something and working it. And no matter how many times you fail, you keep trying because we weren't the first place he came.
Trying to do this thing that it wasn't like a me thing, it had to be a we thing. I wanted the team to accept me, the coaches to accept me, and the institution to accept it. And I think that they've all done that. The kids have been awesome. Can't say it any different.
Moore made this team based on his kicking ability. Now, he hasn't played in any of the Bulldogs' three games this season, but when and if he does, he'll be the oldest player on record at the JUCO level, and he'll be ready.
My time will come. I think my time will come whenever everything's right.
An inconceivable idea to most has turned into his life's mission.
It wasn't if I was going to kick somewhere in the state of Mississippi, it was where I was going to kick. I'll keep to that commitment to the very last second of the very last game. It's been life-changing. It's changed a lot. It's changed things around, the way I think, the way I do things.
And now Moore's next chance at making some history, getting in a game, will be Thursday. Holmes will host Northeast Mississippi Community College. One is the top center in the state and signed to play basketball next year at Georgetown. The other, a highly rated junior recruit set to make his mark in football. Together, these brothers form a famous family.
They're kooky, mysterious and spooky. They're all together ooky, the Addams Family. Their house is a museum. When people come to see them, they really are a scream.
the Addams Family.
It's all about competing, you know. Like if I have a bad game, he'll mess with me. And if he have a bad game in football, I'll mess with him. So, you know, don't nobody want to get picked on.
We argue a lot sometimes. We have a lot of disagreements, but it's good. He way hard on me. I ain't that hard on him. We used to fight all the time when we lose.
When we were little, you know, we always fought.
We just hate to lose to each other in basketball and video games.
Like, if we played video games, we fought. Played in the backyard, we fought. Went to the park, we fought. So it was all fun and games. I think it'd be hard a little bit, but I think me and him both would be okay.
It's going to be hard. Probably going to miss him a lot when he's gone.
The Addams Family.
And, oh, yeah, there's another brother who's in the eighth grade, already on the varsity basketball team. Big game for the Addams Family tomorrow. Brandon hosts top-ranked Meridian.
Fox 40 Sports.
After losing to Florida Wednesday at the SEC tournament, Mississippi State facing early elimination and an early game against Arkansas. Dogs may have been snoozing on the job in the first inning. Already down a run. Moore are going to score on the Matt Reynolds single, and then the error out in right field. Hogs holding that 4-0 lead to the fourth. Hey, some signs of life. Nick Vickerson, the star of the tournament for MSU, doubles in Jared Parks. Next batter, next pitch. It is Jerron Shepard, does the same. That's as close as MSU gets. They're the first team out in Hoover, falling 7-2.
I thought we came out a little bit lethargic, and I think our kids answered that, you know, the last seven or eight innings. But I know they're disappointed, but I know we're a better team than that.
When I came in, he shook my hand and said, great job. And I said, there's no way you're taking me out. I can't. And I haven't had one before, and this is my best chance.
Through all he's accomplished at Southern Miss, Todd McGinnis had never thrown a complete game until last night in USM's opening win of the Conference USA tournament. The Northwest Rankin alum gave the outing of his career. Four hits, only one run given up, and he goes the distance in the 6-1 Golden Eagles victory.
Being back here at home, I had so many people here to come support me and this team, and it was just a great feeling, a great atmosphere. It just made everything so much better. And I just came out there and competed as best as I could. And the defense played great behind me again. So, I mean, it was unbelievable.
Hey, and Todd wasn't the only Golden Eagle tossing from the mound last night. The gunslinger himself throwing out the first pitch. And Mr. Brett Favre, one of the team's biggest fans, now getting a chance to follow them a little more in retirement.
It's been 25 years since I threw out a pitch. But I was excited. I'm excited for obviously Southern Miss in this tournament, but I'm excited that I was asked to throw out the first pitch.
Now, USM will play later tonight against Houston. Early games, UCF wins on a Jonathan Griffin homer in the eighth, 6-4 over UAB. Memphis got five in the first against Rice, and no more. Owls come all the way back to win 8-5. And right now, East Carolina and Tulane are tied 1-1 in the fifth inning. Southern Miss will play in about 30-45 minutes when that game finishes.